We are doing a practice 10 today. It's a force 5 gusting 6 coming in a westerly direction. The yachts were all going to go over to Seacliff, which is like directly over there. But we've called it off. We're going to have a picnic in the clubhouse. But today I thought we would still go out for a little donder, try and get out in the 5-6, do a reach, come back, see what it's like with 3 adults in the boat, and then coming back into the harbour and just do a quick out and in and see what it's like. Okay, so I came out to the point to see what the wind is like. And that's something else when you get white horses coming off just a half mile of land, you know. That's definitely more like a 6 than a 5. I think today's sailing practice is practicing to say no. Yeah, I think it's a no. The sensible thing is no. The thing is, I know that we can sail in this if push comes to shove. But this isn't a push and this isn't a shove, it's a choice. And one of the things is coming out of here when you're rowing, if the wind catches you at the side, it can turn the boat around. And I mean, we can get out there, but there's always a risk. And why risk it when you don't have to is probably the best decision. What would I do on the Ireland to Iona trip in this scenario? Well, we would probably choose not to sail in a 4-6. Well, we will choose not to sail in a 4-6. We will probably sail in a 5-6 if, you know, we feel we had to and there's a time pressure. But if it was early on, we might just, you know, wait out for a bit or a day or a half day. But a lot of it also comes down to wind direction. So, you know, a force 5-6 is no problem on a reach, and it's not really a problem on a close haul either with 4 people in the boat. But if it's a reach and you're not having to tack tight into the wind, but you're kind of going at 45 degrees to the wind or down from the wind, then yeah, that's really easy because it's highly powered, you're not heeling the boat as much, etc. So a lot of it comes down to wind direction as well. So if we were doing the Ireland to Iona trip, we would probably just dial back on a force 5-6. But if we were out there and we were entering into a force 5-6, we could sail through it. And we would probably sail through it to a place of refuge, a beach, a quiet beach, and wait it out until it died down to a force 4 or 5. Langoustines in Dunbar. Show it to my daughter. So that's the male.
That's the male. It's got a narrower tail.
Narrow tail.
And big claws.
Big claws. That's a fatter tail.
Short claws.
Right. How old is that then? It's got barnacles on it.
Yeah, well, the big ones get lazy, you see? Kind of like old people.
Right.
They live in holes like rabbits.
Right.
Down, like, almost like a tree, there's one.
I am so chuffed. One of the fishermen here gave me a life raft. 4-person life raft that, you know, is perfect. It's what you would have in a commercial vessel. It's not necessary for a vessel like this, but having a life raft for the expedition would be amazing. It's for 4 people. It's got flares in it. It's got a tent on it. It's got lights, flares, everything. And it fits just under the tiller area. I think it could work. So I came to see whether it would work with the tiller, and it does perfectly. There's no, it's just absolutely perfect. Absolutely perfect. There's enough space to step in here. I might actually move it forward slightly, you know, and fix it in that kind of position. So you still can stand up that side, to step in and out of the back. Yes, yes, fantastic.